here on the beautiful campus of the University of Prince Edward Island that finalists from across Canada have gathered, and over the next week are going to be taking part in the Canada-wide Science Fair 2012. I want to explain two terms. That's delegates and finalists. Now, those are the people that come from each region. I'm a delegate. Delegates are the adults. So I'm the delegate that represents the region of Durham in Ontario. The students that come here are known as the finalists because they have won their regional science fair. All of the finalists have gathered in the exhibit hall today because this is setup day. That the finalists are gathering in the exhibit hall, and they're going to be putting their projects and experiments on display for the general public and for schools that are visiting. Today is judging day, and behind me there, all of the students are heading out to the exhibition hall, and that's where they spend time with judges. Today, the representative of the Durham District School Board, Andy Glendinning, has a meeting with six different judges. They're 20-minute meetings. Let's see how his day was. Still dressed for judging. How many judges did you see today?
I was supposed to see six. It was scheduled for six, but I got seven extra judges.
So 13 judges, a full day of answering questions. Was it good?
Yeah, it went really well. It went really smooth. If you know your stuff, it goes really well.
Did you hit all the points that you wanted to hit?
Well, there's some presentations where, like, I maybe missed one, but it doesn't really matter as long as you have the other ones.
Right. You got so much to talk about. All in all, a good experience?
Yeah, it was really good experience. PEI is an amazing place to be.
Yeah. Were the judges intimidating?
Not at all. They were actually really friendly. It's just like the regional fair, but longer.
Nice. So, okay, was it more like an interview where they asked questions and you answered?
Yeah. Like,
did it ever turn into like a conversation?
Yeah, pretty much. It flows like a conversation. If you don't know what they're asking, you just ask them to repeat the question. It's not a big deal. Not stressful at all.
Makes total sense. Thanks. Judging day is over, and now it is time for the Charlottetown Challenge. They've divided all the students up into groups. I'm in group number 12 with Andy right there. The challenge has begun.
Where are we going?
I don't know. So each night all the finalists and delegates gather in a lounge. They can do things here like ping pong and video games and just generally hanging out and eating food, and there's plenty of food, great food. This morning we're going to head out for tour day, but in the meantime, if you see right behind me, this is a CBC van. What's happening today is they're broadcasting the morning radio show from our cafeteria.
Canada-wide Science Fair, Mitch Cormier, the Sheldon to my Leonard.
Or maybe it's the other way around.
We're off for a day. This usually happens every science fair. There's usually a tour day where we can see a little bit about the local sites, and tourist traps, and history. All right, it's Thursday morning, and after our busy days, you can really see how tired everybody is. Behind me, it's the cafeteria. It's 25 minutes into breakfast, and as of 5 minutes ago, I was the only one, and right now, there's very few people in here, and usually this place is packed full of finalists and delegates, but today, you can clearly see how tired our schedule has made everybody. They better get down here, because in about an hour, we're back to work. It's 8:20 right now, and it got considerably busy. It's going to be a busy day ahead of us. Today's awards day. And Andy's going to be in his exhibition hall doing some VIP tours. All right. We can hear the contingent from Quebec. It's kind of crazy around here. Andy's got his suit on. And now we are at the awards banquet. The Confederation Center of the Arts right here in Charlottetown. And you can see everybody's all dressed up. So we're standing and waiting to go in. And right beside me, this is Todd Mercer. And Todd, what's your job here?
I'm here, I'm called an ambassador, and that means that I'm a former participant that has been brought in to volunteer and interact with the students throughout the week.
So if they have issues or questions, you're the go-to guy.
Exactly. We've been here and done that, so we know the answer to most of the questions.
And they can certainly trust you because you've been through it.
Exactly.
Perfect. Thanks, Todd.
Bienvenue à la cérémonie de remise des prix de la 51e expo-sciences pan-canadienne. Welcome to the 51st Canada-wide Science Fair Award Ceremony.
Une bonne main d'applaudissements pour nos récipiendaires d'air de la médaille de bronze. Congratulations to our junior bronze medal.
Adrian Au and Nathan Bergman from Kerry Mainland, British Columbia. Yep. The Canada-wide Science Fair 2012 Best Project Award winner is Laurent Jolicoeur.
There's Dominic. Hey Dominic, that was the host, the MC of today.
It was super interesting.
That was an outstanding show.
Yeah. Thank you. Did my BlackBerry to take your video?
Is that BlackBerry by Rim?
Yeah.
For chance?
Oh yeah.
Yes. Rim is a sponsor, so we want to make sure we name that.
Exactly.
Because sponsors are important to run a science fair like this. They do cost a lot of money.
Yeah, it does. Yes.
So thanks, Dominic.
No problem.
There you go. Some delegates in the background there. We're just waiting for the bus to head back. It's been a pretty busy day. Congratulations again. You made us all proud. I can't even think anymore. We're so tired. It is 9 o'clock on Thursday, the day of the awards show. And right behind, in front of us, so I'm going to turn this way, is our lounge. And in that lounge is usually where we play lots of games. And as you can see, it's very empty. There's only a few adults in there. Where are they? Let's go find out. Come on. Come with me. Come this way. Okay, I'm sure you can hear the music. Let's go check it out. One of the most exciting things about being at a Canada-wide science fair is all the people that you'll meet. You meet people from all over Canada, from places like these.
Yukon. Woo!
Northwest Territories.
BC. Alberta.
Saskatchewan.
Manitoba.
Ontario.
Quebec.
New Brunswick.
Nova Scotia.
DEI.
Okay, if you're lucky enough to go to the Canada-wide Science Fair, you won't just meet people from Canada, you actually meet people from outside of the country. And this year we had two countries exhibit and visit. One was Taiwan and the other one was Australia. So this is Jeff from Australia. How is it that you came? Who came with you?
It's extraordinary. I'm glad you asked that. But we each year have six students who are in grade 12
They come from all around Australia and they come to Canada because they want to meet other young scientists like themselves and increase their network. And you can increase your network too by coming to the science fair and meeting some Aussies like these guys behind you. Look, we'd love to talk now, but wow, we've got to catch another international flight.
I'm down on the floor of the science fair and I'm standing right beside Dominic Tremblay. Now, Dominic was our MC yesterday, but more importantly, he knows something about SMARTS. So what do you do for SMARTS?
I do manage a network. It's a network for young scientists to work together.
A social network.
Yeah, I prefer not to call it a social network, but more like an online community, because we all work together on SMARTS. And similar to other social networks, you can post photos, videos, your comments, make friends. But we also have a new feature, which is called the plug, P-L-O-G. You heard about that?
I have. It's very important, but I would love for you to explain it.
It's like a blog, but for projects, so we call it plug. And it's a way for you to document your science fair project and get feedback from your friends.
Fantastic. And what's the web address for that?
It's SMARTS, and SMARTS with an S at the end.
Yep.
youthscience.ca.
Fantastic. Thanks, Tremblay. Thanks, Tremblay.
Dominic.
Thanks, Dominic. It's quarter after 11 on the last day. Very shortly, in about 45 minutes, we're going to clear out the finalists, clear out all the public, and right after lunch, we're actually going to start taking everything apart. So what we see here is going to disappear pretty quickly. It is the end. Everybody's tearing things apart. Even Andy here. It's almost like the week after Christmas around here. You know, we're trying to put the trees away. We won't see all these decorations until next year again, but at least we know it's coming back next year. All right, we're down to the last night. It is the day before everybody leaves. And to celebrate where we've been, they've got a celebration going on called Remember PEI. Woo! All right, it's the last morning. I was lying in bed. It's about 10 after 5. Couldn't sleep and I thought I'd come say goodbye.
Yeah.
So all the people leaving. This is one of the buses. Could be the first bus leaving. This is Little John Pittman from Peace River,
Alberta.
Alberta.
Yeah, hey. Hey, what's up, everybody? We could be the first bus leaving, but we're actually the second bus leaving.
Oh,
but,
those people are crazy, the first one.
Oh, this is wild, man. We got a 4:30 wake-up time for a 6 o'clock flight. It's fantastic. I just want to let you know, folks, know that this has been the best science fair of life ever, and I want to encourage all students out there to just get involved. You guys, you can do it, you know. Just because you're from a small town doesn't mean your ideas are little or big, man. Just connect with someone who knows it, and best of luck. Keep learning from this guy. You guys have lots of fun, and we'll see you next year. Canada Wide Science Fair.
Fantastic.
Woo! Woo! Go get them.
It is travel day. Officially, the science fair is over. It's just more and more buses throughout the day. Lots of people coming and going. Actually, more going than coming, but you know what I mean.